Good evening, everybody. Welcome to the press conference of the Croatian national team ahead of the match against Scotland. First of all, let me apologize for our delay, which was caused by a flight delay in Zagreb and then in Glasgow again due to the fog, even though we didn't see it. Feel free to ask questions in English. I will translate the answers back to English, but both coach and player will speak only in Croatian. I'm pleased to be joined by our head coach, Mr. Zlatko Dalic, and our player, Mateo Kovacic, and let's start. You've been waiting, so I'm sure you have a lot of good questions. For either the coach or the player. Damel.
A možda da krenemo s izvornih podoreća, da čujemo do početak jer bi sve u redu imali kakvih novosti jer su svi na raspolaganju i možemo li doznati neke od ideja za sutrašnju.
Dobro večer, veliki pozdrav svima. Ono što je jasno, da će nas čekati teška utakmica pred punim stadionom i jedan protiv koji će biti energičan, agresivan, borben, željan dobrog rezultata i još uvijek oni imaju svoje ambicije, svoje šanse za bolji plasman. Nama ne preostaje drugo nego da uđemo pametnu utakmicu, da uđemo sa strpljenjem i da napravimo što želimo. Ja bih htio da mi kroz ovdje sutra napravimo rezultat da imamo prolazak u četvrtfinal Lige nacija. Imat ćemo dosta tešku utakmicu. Ono što vas znam da vas zanima što će, kad će, kako će, pogotovo osobito vratar, da ne ispada nikad ništa nikad ne kaže, evo Branko će Kotarski.
The question was about the situation in the team ahead of this game. The coach said we expect a tough game. It's going to be a full stadium. Scotland is sure to have a lot of ambition and energy for this game. They still have their ambitions in the group. And we need to be smart, we need to be patient. And we want to achieve a result that will qualify us for the quarterfinals of the Nations League. Usually you say that I don't talk too much about our lineup, so today I'll make an exception and I'm sure you want to know who is going to be the goalkeeper and it's going to be Kotarski.
Onda mogu i za Matea, Mateo, drago nam je da ste opet s reprezentacijom, kako vi gledate na ovo što nas čeka sada, prije svega na uvijek sutra protiv Škotske, sigurni smo da je pobjeda, kao što je izgledan, jer je to glavni cilj.
Najprije dobro večer svima, pa je, znamo da je nas čeka teška utakmica, kao što je Izvornik već rekao. Škoti su nezgodni, ja sam igrao već par puta protiv njih i nikad nije bilo jednostavno, tako da znamo da nas očekuje jedan dobar agresivan protivnik igrati od kuće, gdje nikad nije lako doći igrat, ali radili smo dobro par dana, pripremili smo se i nadam se da ćemo kujove koja pružiti pravu utakmicu i imati rezultate, jer to nam trenutno treba za dalje prolazak.
The question for Mateo was his preview of the game tomorrow. Mateo said we expect a tough game. I've played against Scotland several times and it was never easy. We expect them to be aggressive. They're playing at home, so it's never easy to play here. But we worked really well throughout this week and we hope to have a good result tomorrow.
Evo, mogu da ja nastavim za izbornika pitanje zašto Kotarski, kad smo dobili jednu temu. A za Mateja jedno pitanje, Mateo, evo, danas u avionu, pa na aerodromu, u taksiju, u hotelu, u gradu, svi znaju da se igra sutra ta neka utakmica i svi kažu da velika reprezentacija dolazi Škotskoj u gostu. To je sigurno lijepo čuti još jedan dokaz zapravo tog nekakvog imidža vašeg kojeg ste izgradili tijekom ovih godina.
Pa ja ću oko vratara, imamo zaista osim Livakovića, tri vratara koja su bila u krugu reprezentacije u Ligi nacija. Ja sam kao što je bio rekao da smo mi dogovorili sa stožerom i sa njima, da će uvijek jedan njih pauzirati, da ne zbog toga što je neko višak. Odluka i predlog struke, odnosno dečki u stožeru ulaskom da to bude Kotarski, ja sam prihvatio, brani u Europi, njegov klub igra, brani u klubu dobro, ima sigurnost, ali mislim da smo se učili bilo koga dobe trojice, ne bi pogriješili. Najpošli poziciju moj ušti, ovo je zakasnio dva dana zbog svojih obveza opravdanih, pa onda sam nisam uvijek polio tim dilema i naša odluka i Glavovića i Kotarskog odbrana i Kotarski. Nada se mi to na nivou, kako je u klubu, kako je na pionskim utakmicama.
Pa je, kao što ste rekli, jako lijepo čuti takve stvari. Mislim da smo svojim ponašanjem na terenu i na terenu, naravno, svojim rezultatima i svojim igrom zadnjih godina pokazali da smo velika reprezentacija i lijepo čuti da nas ljudi cijene, na to treba potvrđivati i dan u dan i sutra imamo novu priliku, novu tešku utakmicu da pokažemo naš stil igre, kako smo pomenuli od Ligi nacija sad. Pokazali smo igrali odlično, da imamo i jako dobru poziciju, nismo drugi, tako da ovaj teška utakmica sutra i nadam se da će biti pravi.
Question for the coach was about the goalkeeper. How did he decide on Kotarski? Coach said that we have three goalkeepers along with Livaković, who have been with us during this Nations League. I listened to the suggestions of our goalkeeping coaches. Kotarski is playing really good in his club. He's playing in Europe as well. He's in good shape. All three would be good choices, but we decided to go with Kotarski. Question for Mateo was about the respect that Croatia seemed to have here in Scotland among the fans and the media here, and what does he think about that? Mateo said that it's always nice to hear something like that. I think we deserved it with our results, with our play, with our behavior over the last few years. It's nice to be appreciated, but we also need to confirm that, reaffirm that in each game. We played well so far in the Nations League. We expect a tough game tomorrow, but we want to show our worth again. HRTS iz Puco. I radio, televizija. Dalje.
Draže. Pitanje za Matea. Sad i u klubu i reprezentaciji igraš nekako u zadnjih prezlog, mogu bi se reći šesticu. Voliš li to igrati?
Pa, novost mi je. Nisam igrao to drugo, ja sam pa navrata ovaj nekad najedat, ali volim. Mislim da je malo teže, moraš biti još odgovorniji i bolje se pozicionirati. Učim iz dana u dan, radim na tome, tako da si bilo da defenzivno mogu još dosta puno se popraviti u tom smislu, ali volim. Ja, pogotovo sam u City-u, jako puno sam u kontaktu s loptom, što meni naravno odgovara, i u reprezentaciji sam, evo, možda ne jedina šestnica, ali u paru s Lukom se tu obojice dobro osjećamo, tako da pozicija koja mi se sviđa i mogu puno još napredati po meni.
Question for Mateo was about his position, because during this season he's been playing number 6 a lot, both in the club and in the national team, and how does he feel about that? Mateo said that it's something new to him, even though he played some games before, but he likes the position. He believes he can play even better. It's a little bit more difficult because there's more responsibility. You need to be positioned really well, and he thinks that defensively he can improve even more. He likes it in Man City because he's in touch with the ball a lot, and in Croatian national team he plays the position alongside Luka, and he thinks that works really well for both of them.
Matteo, this is for Matteo. You have played in England, obviously, for a number of years, so you'll be quite knowledgeable about a lot of the Scottish players who play there. Who are the main danger men from your point of view, do you think?
I don't like to speak about individuals because... ne volim pričati puno o pojedincima, jer mislim da su Škoti jedna ekipa koja baš momčad, vidi se to da se bori jedno za drugog i to pokazuju već dugi niz godina, ali ako bi već morao nekog istaknuti, jako mi se sviđa Billy Gilmour, s kojim sam igrao u Chelsea, koji je puno napredao zadnjih godina, i uvijek volim isticati John McGinn, zato što uvijek mi je bilo teško jer protiv njega, koji igra jako dobro vlastno bili zadnjih godina, strašno jako u duelu, jak na lopti, igrač kojim se sada vraća, kojim nije bilo u Zagrebu protiv nas, tako da to je jedan veliki plus za Škoti.
Mateo said that he doesn't like to speak a lot about individual players, especially since Scotland is such a strong team and they fight for each other very well, but since you asked me, I would say Billy Gilmore, who I know from Chelsea, and he really improved over the last couple of years. And it's always very difficult for me to play against John McKinn. He's a very tough, strong player. He's been playing really well for Aston Villa, and he's coming back. He didn't play in Zagreb, and I think he will make Scotland much better.
Hi, yeah. It's another question for Matteo. With your club, Man City, being on such a bad run at the moment, is international football a good distraction for you?
To ćemo vidjeti, ako dobijemo sutra, naravno da je to nešto pozitivno. Naravno, situacija u Cityu nije najidealnija, ali to se dešava, to je nogomet, imaš naših poleraka koje jednostavno se desi. Na nama je da se što prije oporavimo od toga. Naravno da ova stanka je dobro došla trenutno, da se malo maknemo jedni od drugih, da malo se i odmorimo i da igramo za svoje zemlje i da se onda vratimo nakon ovog ciklusa spremni za nov pobjed.
But I said, we'll see tomorrow. If we win, then I'll feel much better about that. As for the club, it's not ideal at the moment, but that's something that happens over the course of the season. Probably this break is something that's good for us, just to have our minds on something else. And then when we come back from the international break, that we start to try to win again.
Can I ask the manager just what kind of game he's expecting against Scotland?
Pa, zaista, veliki respekt za prestaciju Škotske. Oni nisu zaslužili na ovoj poziciji koji sad jesu s jednim bodom. Izgubili su utakmice i Portugal i od Hrvatske od Poljske u zadnjim minutama i jako, jako teško. Dobra reprezentacija koja je bila konkurentna sve ovo vrijeme i zaista očekujem agresivnu reprezentaciju, jedan dobar nogomet i čvrstu utakmicu, neće biti ni malo lako.
We have a lot of respect for the Scottish team. I think they deserved much more during this Nations League cycle. In all the games against Portugal, Poland and us, they lost points in the last minutes. So they're a tough, very competitive team. So we expect a difficult and good game tomorrow.
Just asked Matthew, have you spoken to Billy Gilmore about this game and you're going to play? How much are you looking forward to coming up against Billy, and have you been watching him in his first few months in Italy? It's going well.
Pa nisam s njim, čuo sam se prije utakmice u Zagrebu, malo smo razmijenili par poruka, ništa specijalno, ali da, pratim ga, volim nogomet, tako da volim gledat razne momčine, razne lige i pratim nekad i Napoli i kako bili igra i kao što sam rekao, on je odličan igrač koji je puno napredao, koji će još napredovati i veselim se sutra ga vidjeti na terenu.
We haven't been in touch before this game, but we were in touch over the text messages before the game in Zagreb. I like to watch football in general, so I watch a lot of games, including Napoli. He really developed, as I said before, over the last few years, and he still has room for further development, so I'm looking forward to see him tomorrow and play against him. Yeah.
Matteo, again, just one last one for me on Billy Gilmore. As a youngster coming through at Chelsea, did you always expect that he could go on to that higher level? And are you surprised to see him playing in Serie A?
Pa nisam iznenađen. Od prvog dana kad je došao kod nas, stvarno se vidio da ima veliki kvalitet, da je drugačiji i odskakuje po meni dosta mlađih igrača i jako karakteran. Vidi se da želi napred, da želi učiti. Ima veliki talent, tako da ne iznenađe me uopće i siguran sam da će napraviti veliku karijeru. Već ima jako dobro, a bit će još bolje.
No, I'm not surprised. I've seen from the first day that he had a really high quality. He was better than the other young players. He wants to learn. He has a big talent, and I'm sure he's going to have a big career. It's already really good, but I expect him to improve even more.
Ajde, za kraj samo jedno. Treba mikrofon ili može ovako?
Evo, podrži.
Evo, izbrniće za kraj, ako možemo završiti, evo, s jednim osobnim iskustvom. Danas bio sam na treningu škotskom njihovom kampu, onako dočekali su nas jako ljubazno i u razgovoru sa članovima njihovog stožera, dvojica su došla do mene i pitala su me u čemu je tajna, mi smo zemlja od 6,5 milijuna stanovnika, nikada nismo prošli skupinu na velikom natjecanju, a vi ste još manji od nas, pa ste osvojili dvije medalje sa svjetskih prvenstava, imate finale Lige nacija, tri, ali dvije u ovom mandatu od ove generacije. Kažu, u čemu je tajna, objasnite nam. Ja, nažalost, nisam mogao proglasiti neku infrastrukturu ili dugogodišnje ulaganje u nogomet kao razlog, ja sam naveo talent kao neko opravdanje, pa me zanima što bi vi rekli da vas Škoti pitaju isto pitanje, zašto mi ne možemo kroz cijelu povijest, a vi koji ste manji od nas imate dvije medalje sa svjetskih prvenstava, finala Lige nacija u samoj zadnjih.
Pitali ste to u Zagrebu?
Pa dobro, kao si rekao, prvo talent i kvalitete igrača, to je neupitno, i nova reprezentacija koja je dugi godina od 2008. pravi dobre rezultate, za nje vrijeme osobito, ali pored te kvalitete, naravno je dobar rad, dobra i priprema i dobre trenizi i dobra taktika i dobra selekcija, sve to je se poklopilo, ali ono što je najvažnije da su igrači kvalitetni i da je to plod i nove dečkove rada, jer ne možeš imati samo sreću da bi nešto napravio, biti drugi na svijetu, treći na svijetu ili Lige nacija, treba ti sreća, ali kvaliteta igrača, dobar rad, dobra selekcija, dobra taktika, dobra priprema, sve kompletno. I jedno zajedništvo koje nas krasi i jedna ona nekako naša nota toga ponosa i sreće kad si u prezentaciji, i to je ono što je najvažnije. I mislim da će dugo vremena proći, da će neka zemlja, učine kao što je Hrvatska, nešto napraviti. Mislim da je Uruguay bio 30. i mi nakon 100 godina mi. Da. Tako da, tako mala zemlja, nada da se to nešto potraja, da će biti još uspjeha rezultata, ali oni puno toga se poklopila i generacije koje dolaze mlađi igrači, ali kažem, pitan je rad koji se kod nas atmosfera, ambijent, zajedništvo i sve skupa daje pot.
The question was about the secret of the secret for the success of the Croatian team over the last 30 years, especially the last 7 or 8. The coach said, first of all, it's talent and of the players, their quality, and of course everything that goes along with that: hard work, good training sessions, good preparation, good tactics. A good selection that we have in Croatia, and of course one of the main ingredients of our success is the togetherness and the unity of the team, a really good atmosphere that we have, the pride and joy and patriotism that our players play with. I don't think any national team of this size of the population will repeat similar success that Croatia had at the last 2 World Cups. I think the last country of our size was Uruguay in the 1950. They played in the World Cup final, and hopefully we can manage to continue with this kind of success going forward.
Wow. Also a great card.
Is that it? If it is, thank you very much. Thank once you again, apologies and.